my. Oh, wow, she's beautiful. I'm sure I've seen her before. I have to find her. And here she is. My, she's a beauty. Star Union have been supplying parts and components for e-mobility for decades, so have built vast knowledge and experience in the design, engineering, and manufacture of each. This has been applied to our range of center motors for e-bikes. The drive system is designed to give different characteristics to the bike it's built into and has various options, each of which we'll overview one by one. Firstly, the center motor is both the brains and the brawn of the system. Inside, a motor powers the bicycle while the central control unit, the CCU, receives the sensor information, processes it, and instructs the motor control unit, the MCU, to power the motor. The center motor is mounted low down in the frame and also includes the bottom bracket, the BB. This means that the bicycle looks and rides just like a regular bicycle, but with more power. It remains compatible with standard bicycle parts, and even the law says that an e-bike, such as this, is a bicycle. So most places do not require a license, registration, or even a helmet. Importantly, a center motor helps you along the way, especially up those hills. Because the weight is low down, as long as you can ride a normal bicycle, you can ride an e-bike. The center motor knows when you're pedaling, so helps you get started, go faster, and keeps you cruising when you want the help. After a while, you won't even know it's there. Until, of course, you're back to riding a standard bicycle again and wonder why it's not so easy. There are also various sensors dotted around the bike, but more on those later. Many have asked us if our center motors can be tuned to achieve 100 kilometers an hour. While you can trick the CCU, we do not recommend doing this, and each country has its regulations related to the speed and roadworthiness. For me, it's just about enjoying the ride. Up top is the HMI, the human-machine interface. This includes a remote and a display, perhaps even integrated together. The display tells you what you need to know about the bicycle, your speed, the battery life, and assist setting, for example. The remote puts you in control of the ride and is mounted right next to the grip for ease of access. We currently offer three types of drive system. For European pedalecas, we combine CM2502 with SW102. Then for the stealthy cyclists, CM2503 can be matched with DZ47 and SW102. And then for the urban environment, CM2503 and SW102 is the best bet. For the power hungry, we have CM2505 or CM5001. Both of these are paired with DS103. Links for more information are available through our channel. Now, to see how it works, follow me down the rabbit hole, and in the words of Tina Turner, let's get technical. Let's get technical, technical. We've designed this range to be quiet and lightweight. This is the CM2502. Normally it is sealed shut, but I've asked our engineers to open one for you. We won't look at all the parts in detail, just the highlights. First, this box houses the computer, called the Central Control Unit, the CCU. While it might look now like Wally's spaghetti dinner, this is where all the wires from the system connect. All wires lead to Rome because this is where the brains are located. Remember? All center motors have speed and torque sensors that keep you in control. This means all the sensors bring in information and the rider also adjusts the assistance desired while the computer tells the lights to shine and how fast the motor should be spinning. There are two groups of sensor, passive and active. Passive sensors measure and detect the environment and include torque, cadence and speed sensors. These respond to motion and force in the environment to help the CCU decide how much assistance to provide. For the US and other regions and territories, an e-bike with a throttle is still a bicycle. So we offer a pedal-free motor actuation option, or the throttle for short. This is an active sensor as it is mentally controlled by the rider. If the rider wants more or less assistance, they press the relevant button on the remote to change the assistance level. Back to the motor. This is the clutch, which comes in two parts. One and two. This is the MCU, or motor control unit. This gets the signal from the CCU and decides how much power to give the motor. Over here is the drive gear. And to keep the weight low and maintain good durability, we use a plastic pom gear, which also reduces noise. This motor is very powerful. Power is measured in watts, and this has a peak power of 680 watts. The motor is rated for sustained output of 250 watts due to laws and regulation. Inside the motor, there are two magnetic parts. The rotor, which moves, within the stator, which is stationary and does not move. The electric power is controlled by the MCU to run through the copper wires to generate an electric field that both repels and attracts the stator, making the drive axle spin. The copper wire is machine wound so the physical product matches our engineer's drawings. This means our motors are even more efficient than hand wound motors, because all the electricity is used to make the same magnetic field. This also means the motor spins stably and consistently and without vibration. It is vibration that we hear, so our motors are very quiet. Before I mention that this motor, the CM2505, is rated 500 watt, with peak power exceeding 900 watt. That is the maximum sustained or rated power allowed for the assistance to remain a bicycle under US law and traffic regulations. Even a professional Tour de France cyclist would struggle to generate that much power for a long period. Recall, an electric motor spins at around 3800 RPM, or revolutions per minute. Most people have a cadence of 60 to 120 RPM, so we build a gear system that steps the motor speed down to match your pedal speed, so it does not take over from you, but helps you and keeps you in control. As the gears spin, the drive axle is rotated and this power is transferred to the axle. In summary, the motor spins quietly due to machine wound design. This drives the gear system that steps down the speed while increasing the torque or power of the motor. The CM2502 and CM2503, well, these are limited in European law to 250 watts. So we have developed every option for our EU customer. Both motors are rated below 250 watts, so e-bikes for these motors qualify as bicycles in Europe. CM2502 is larger, used on city bikes, while as CM2503 is very small and has a slightly lower torque. Could be used on folding bikes or just any hidden bike. Back to that motor power. The power leaves the motor and gets to your wheels. Recall the drive axle. This is driven directly by the motor. This is coupled through the gearbox to the drive cog. The drive cog powers the BB axle through the clutch that combines both the rider and motor outputs and delivers this smoothly to the rear wheel. Recall in the EU that motors have a lower rated power, so we reduce engine noise by using a POM cog, without sacrificing durability. For the 500 watt motors, CM5001 and CM2505, we use an aluminium alloy. Because the motor is very powerful, so our durable design calls for metal. Now moving on from the drive unit, we will explore the active controls. Remember, these are the sensor inputs that you mentally control. The display may be basic, showing the battery life and assist setting, or it may be packed with more detail, including speed, range, and power. Our displays are weatherproofed above IPX5 to keep rain and snow out. We have a variety of throttles available, just like a motorbike. Pulling back on the grip or pressing the thumb throttle down increases the motor output. Our systems can also be electronically and electrically connected to additional components. We use a CAN bus communications protocol, just like in a car, so the lights can be simply switched on and off. Brakes with an optional safety cutoff switch send a signal directly to the motor to immediately stop the motor. This stops the motor fighting against the brakes, so saves battery power and reduces wear on both motor and brake parts. The remote switches on the drive system, adjusts assistance level, and may also control the lighting and warp mode features. The remote is truly remote and connected to the display by this cable. The remote is also weatherproofed and ergonomically designed. The CM2505 and CM5001
Both use the DS-103 to help keep an eye on all that power. The SW-102 is used for the traditional and sensible European CM-2502. Hidden at the back is a stealthy DZ-47. To stay hidden and confuse onlookers, the display is small yet perfectly formed to clearly communicate key criteria. That's a brief overview of the Star Union Drive systems currently available. Now get out there and enjoy the ride.